Good evening. A man has given himself up and is being questioned by detectives tonight after the body of a 19-year-old woman was found lying in a bath of acid at a North Parramatta unit. The confronting scene has horrified officers who had to break their way inside late yesterday before launching a manhunt.
A desperate drive for Meraj Zafar as he flees his home after allegedly killing his partner. Officers found the 19-year-old's body inside the couple's North Parramatta unit after the accused man called a relative, panicking that they'd had a fight.
Officers forced entry to the unit, and inside the bathroom they found the body of a female.
I was in the backyard yesterday, and at about 2 o'clock I heard somebody, it sounded like they were about to sing. And then it turns straight into a bit of a scream.
Arnima Hayat was dead in the bathtub, soaked in acid. Hazmat crews called in.
The scene was very challenging for arriving police. When they did arrive and found chemicals inside the unit, they retreated and called hazmat officers, who then spent several hours at the scene.
A major manhunt covered several suburbs, with detectives circulating this image and warning the public to stay away.
It was a little bit of a shock to see that it was just across the road.
Officers went to Zafar's previous addresses in Greenacre and Wiley Park, but after 20 hours on the run, he went to them.
Around midday, the suspect handed himself into Bankstown police station. Officers then found his getaway truck dumped here at Greenacre Bunnings, and it will now be taken for forensic examination.
The couple's home was intensely examined throughout the day, and potential evidence was seized for testing. A kitten also removed from the unit.
And live to Natasha Squarey at Bankstown Police Station. Natasha, any indication as to what led to this tragedy?
Not yet, Mark. The man is still being questioned here at Bankstown Police Station, but we can confirm the couple does have a history of domestic violence. For now, he is cooperating with detectives, and it's likely he will be charged with one count of murder in the coming hours. For now, he remains locked up and will face court tomorrow morning. Mark.
Natasha, thank you.